Hi, my name is Cassidy Janson, and you're watching Show Circle with Magic at the Musicals. It's a tie between, I think Cats was my first, the first musical I went to see. So it's got a really like lovely place in my heart. But Chicago, the 96 rendition was sort of my big overplayed musical. I loved it. I think I did Cell Block Tango a million times in my living room. It's a very, very special genre of entertainment. Obviously, you have things like Netflix now, and you can have these amazing, you can have films and TV shows streamed in your living room that we didn't really get to that capacity when it was just the four channels. And live entertainment is so valid. It's such a valid form of entertainment, and it is so different. And having everything streamed online at the moment, it's not the same. It's not meant to be streamed online. It's meant to be experienced in the same room with the same atmosphere, with the same, you know, that electricity that you can't film and capture and put through your TV set. It's a in the moment shared experience, and it's wonderful, and it's so missing from everyone's life at the moment. I think everyone's really noticing how live interaction is so necessary to be human. And I think musical theatre, live musical theatre, is very, you know, I personally believe we aren't little machines, we're spiritual beings, and we're not getting the upliftment we normally get. My favourite song in Anne Juliet is, I love it so much. It's got a swear word in, so please, I'm not actually swearing, it's the name of the song. It's called Perfect, and it's sung by the character of Nurse, who's played by the wonderful Melanie LaBarry. And she just sings from the bottom of her soul. And this resonant voice comes out, and she's singing to Juliet, played by the wonderful Miriam Teakley. And it's just such a poignant moment of the show. Most of the show is just very big, epic songs. And this is like this lovely ballad that she just sings very honestly and shares part of her life that you don't really get to see until that moment. I actually can't think about it too much because I miss it so much. I've had to sort of put it in a little compartment in my little universe because it's really painful actually. So I try not to think about it too much. And I just keep thinking each day at a time. It's very hard when you've built your whole life around a certain profession and it seems to be sort of sidelined. So I don't know. I want to say I'm excited, but I'm just sort of emotional. So advice I would give to someone taking on their first big role in a West End would be look after yourself. Try not to let the noise in your head get in the way of your focus because it's very weird being in a big lead role. You know, I think your inner critic can get very loud and just try and trust yourself that you're doing a good thing and just look after yourself because the adrenaline in your body every night is very hard on the body's system. So just try not to have too much caffeine. So if I could be in any other musical apart from Anne Juliet, what would I be in? There's a few that I really love. I love Waitress. Really love Waitress. I think it's a really heartwarming show. I'd love to go back and play Carole King, but obviously the show's not on anymore. I'd like to have another stab at chess with Michael Ball and Alex Burke. That was fun. That was really fun. Yeah, there's a few shows. I would say it's been a mixture of emotions. It's been really lovely to bump into people I didn't expect to bump into, catch up with people. It is a weird thing where it feels almost normal, but also sort of, you know, there's, you know, sort of hearing that it's likely that theatres aren't going to be back until March, April next year. So it was sort of bittersweet. I personally just, and I think a lot of people get thrills off watching a big orchestra and a bit. I'm a huge fan of big horn sections. I didn't have a horn section in my solo, but I've been sitting watching these other performers perform, and we just watched Jesus Christ Superstar, and the horn section get to really show off in that. And I'm literally like, loving my life. So I suppose it's because of the nature of the pandemic, it's enjoying these days. They're not very often, they're few and far between, and just really enjoying them and really embracing them and really sort of the other thing is the appreciation I feel for everybody involved in today and everyone in our profession who's, we're all going through it together. And these little moments of coming together and creating amazing live music is, oh, it's so, such a visceral feeling. It's lovely.